Dear Liberals, we need to have a talk, you and I. I have quite a lot of stuff to say that I want to get off my chest. I have quite a lot of feelings bottled up over here and I need an outlet for them. I want to make clear that this is not an angry rant or an attack, nor is it any attempt at trying to guilt trip or ridicule you. Consider it more like a confession from me to you. An open window into my psyche and a look into the chaos that dwells within. I know that if any of you watch this, then that it will not convince you. Nor am I expecting any of you to change your mind. I had my doubts about making this, but I've been haunted by these negative thoughts lately. And I need to get rid of them. Let us begin. I am going to be completely honest. I don't like you very much. I don't like labeling myself into any political ideology, but if I were to label myself, it would be somewhere in the anarchist side of things. This is important because I know that in North America, complaining about liberals is a very conservative thing to do. I want to make clear that I am not a conservative and I'm very much a left-winger. Anyway, your ideas and your methods are extremely contradictory to me, an anarchist. You support freedom of speech, freedom of expression, and democracy, yet you also support the institute of capitalism, which directly goes counter to that. You want everyone to have the best material conditions. Yet you support the free market, which is one of the least efficient ways of resource allocation, in my opinion. You say that you want the best for people and support civil rights. Yet you are more than willing to throw a truckload of people under the bus if it means preventing the collapse of the economy. You have an extremely individualist way of looking at things. If a cop murders a black person, then said cop is only a bad apple. A single bad one out of the bunch. You get rid of the bad apple, but you don't look at the institution which allowed said apple to rot in the first place. Some of you support LGBTQ+ rights. This is good, but for most of you, it's nothing but a fashion statement. A branding with which to pat yourself on your back with without looking at the plight of queer folk on this planet. You separate the economy and politics and social life from each other, while these are intentionally connected to each other. This all makes you draw what are, in my opinion, the wrong conclusions. I could go on and on and on about this, but I think I've made my point. You are extremely confusing to me, a contradictory mess of old-fashioned ideas that should have been put to rest a century ago. You are extremely frustrating to me as well. You really know how to pull the blood from under my nails, metaphorically speaking. I groan every time I see a liberal online defending imperialist policies of Western countries or misunderstanding left-wing ideas. I groan whenever you claim to support civil rights, but you're also more than willing to disparage an entire group of people just because they're living in a certain geographic area. I think that liberalism is a contradictory mess of a socio-economic ideology whose good parts have been done better by left-wing ideologies and ideas. I know all of this. I have experienced all of this. I am aware of this like many people are. I am not exactly very special in this regard. And yet, I always end up being surprised whenever you do things like this. Look, I'm not going to pretend that I know better than other people. My frustrations with you all are mine alone. You will probably disagree with me on what I just said, and that is fine. I don't have all the answers, no one has. But I think that the main reason why I'm always so frustrated with you all is because I know that most of you don't mean it maliciously. most liberals that I've encountered have their hearts in the right place. It has become difficult in our permanently online world to really empathize with others. Many people see stuff like debates and politics like a battleground where two ideological gladiators fight for supremacy. This is not a world where I want to live in. I don't want to be angry and frustrated all the time. I don't want to spend my days yelling at people online constantly. I just do not really have the stamina for that anymore. Because of that, I want to extend a hand of friendship. Because, as much as I hate to admit it, I don't think that the individual liberal is the enemy. I think that the ideology of liberalism is bad and destructive, but I don't think that it is fair to blame individual liberals for that. We are all products of our environment, after all. I am on the autism spectrum, and because of my circumstances, I will never be able to function properly in our liberal society. I have made peace with this now. I am well aware of my own flaws. I am short-tempered, socially clumsy, I'm very lazy and negative, and I have a egocentric streak. I have been working very hard to improve myself in this regard, but there's only so much I can do on my own. I'm still expected to function in our liberal capitalist society, despite the fact that it is impossible for me to do so. Look, I know that this entire statement is basically me screaming into the void, and I doubt that any liberal will hear this, but in the slight chance that you do, I want you to look at our society. Talk to people less well off than you are and ask them how they came to be in that position. I think that you will find that many of them did so because of circumstances beyond their control. If you think that it was their own fault for getting into that position, even after that, then you should not be surprised when people are criticizing you and calling you out. However, if this changes your mind and you start seeing the structural issues that exist within our society, then I welcome you as a friend, and I hope that one day we can work together on a better world. I have spent so much time and mental energy in getting angry at liberals, both online and the liberals in governments of the world, that I'm quite honestly too exhausted to function properly anymore. I have spent so much mental energy imagining scenarios where I have to explain stuff to people online over and over and over again that it is negatively impacting my mental health. One of the reasons why I'm making this video as well is to give myself closure regarding this. I hope you will understand. I wish you all the best. Best wishes, Pim.